So this is all about forms, which some of you might have known. So forms is some kind of dialogue flow or a input where we can give to users while being us as a developers. We can give users to give some inputs and to show or display some text. So other than covering all the components, I would like to cover only data for now. And that too, from data, the basic things that I would like to highlight are data grid and edit grid. Because remaining elements like text field are just like input fields, but data grid and edit grid are like repeaters. So if you have seen here, okay, we can do from beginning. That will give us some exact knowledge. So there are two types of grids which can be used as repeaters to show a series of data or something like a JSON data, JSON array, or something like this kind of input. Like if you want to show this table in a form, like how exactly we can do it. So that I would like to cover in this. Now here, a data grid alone cannot have a data. So there should be some input field which need to be available so that the data can be present. So in this data concept or in this data grid, I would like to add two things called text field. One, which can be named as, I'll try to rename it as field one. And I will add one more text field in the same place. Okay, let's give it as field C. This will be field 2. I don't think I have added data grid, so let's add some data grid as well. And inside data grid, let's give it a name as grid, which will be the property name. And let's add this text file in this. So what exactly I'm trying to do is, I will not configure this text fields for every row and every column. I'll just configure it once, but the data will be repeated and we can see all the data. So here, let's rename this to field one, save, and let's rename this to field two, and let's rename this to field three. Here in field 1 and field 2, let's add the field 2. So if you are aware, these are just the fields, nothing to link with the data. Let's save it and let's add one more. Cancel the component text field. So I have added three text fields which I will be using to add the data. Now in this, let's add field 3. So I just want to leave everything else. So all we need is a data grid and as well as three input fields where I need to show the data. Let's save this and close. So to show some kind of tabular data into a form, something that we need to do is, first we need to keep an Excel scope and we need to read the sheet. This can be a data table, but we need to convert this string using a JSON convert serialize object and convert this into a, let's keep a breakpoint, and convert this particular data table into a JSON object. Let's debug. Okay, so let's step into and see. Okay, now each and every data is converted into a JSON object. Now let's stop this and let's go to the properties of form field. properties. So if you have seen, this should be the input for the form. Like there can be form field inputs, but I tried this already, but this did not work for me. So the only way I was able to give is in the grid, I added the items, like I passed in the values. In the grid one, I am adding the JSON string. So again, this grid is the name or the key value of this data grid. If you see the key value here, this is the grid, and in this I am giving its input values for each and every field as a JSON object. Okay, so let's remove this edit grid. Later we can see with details about edit grid. And this should always be a JSON input, and which should be converted into a string. So this is a JSON string. And finally, there is no output as of now, but let's use something. There is form fields output. Let's debug this. We are creating a form. Okay, if you have seen, I have added only one field, like three input fields, first one, second one, third one. So this is the use of data grid. So instead of we create all the elements, we will be able to use this data grid and we'll be able to populate all the tabular items. One more important thing is, if a user wants to delete, like if you want to give a user the command that he can delete some rows, and when he submits it, now in this you can see, continue. Now in the output, let's see some values. Okay, in the output, see, we have only two items in an array. So remaining items are deleted by the user. So whatever the items that are available in the current form only will be sent out as an output. So there can be many use cases for this. Like if you want to have a bot where a user should be shown with input, and we need to give some edit options to the user, and upon submitting the form, the data should be saved back in the Excel. This can be done. And let's go back to Open Designer. So I have shown you what is a data grid. Now the difference between data grid and edit grid is, see, in edit grid we will also have an option in the view of a form. Like I'll show you. So this is edit grid. Let's save it. And let's copy this and paste below. So this is field one, and I'll copy this again, paste it, copy, paste. So there are three fields, but I would like to keep the same key values as the previous ones, and field key should be field one. This can be field 2, and this can be field 3. Saved. Let's rename this as well. Field 1, that's fine. Edit, this can be field 2, and edit, this can be field 3. Okay, now if you have seen, the fields are aligned horizontally in data grid, but in edit grid the fields are aligned vertically. So we'll also see how this will come into place while we are updating the form. So instead of this, either I can give edit grid, or else what I can also do is keep a comma and write edit grid and give a colon, again passing the JSON string. JSON string, which will complete the JSON format. Now we have two data grids, one data grid to show the data and the other one to edit for editing. So let's finally check with edit grid. That should be fine. Save, close, and let's rerun this file. So we have a JSON input. Step into the form designer. Now we can see there are two grids, one data grid where we can directly edit the data, but the other one which gives user the access to either edit it. So this is how we design the form. Now when we save or edit something, let's give my name here and let's save it. So when we save back, the form will automatically add all the values to its output JSON, and when we finally submit it, this will be posted back in the output. So in the data grid one, okay, it will be better if you can see like this. So in the data grid one, we have values still here. In data grid two, the field names are changing. So these are the uses that a data grid and a edit grid can be used.
Can you quickly explain once again the same thing, the JSON, how you are passing it? Just one.
So see, for a form, we need to pass or send the values using the key value pair. Okay. So what exactly I'm trying to match is with the input field. So these will be the keys and these will be their values. So for field one, there will be one, and this will be an array when we are converting this into a serialized object. Now when you see or debug this one, step into, okay, so this is a JSON string. So when we have this data table, so field 1, field 2, field 3 are the field names that we need to map with the table. So if we have the same fields, then it's okay. If not, we need to make some code changes to make sure that the keys are matching with the column names. And finally, in these properties, in grid, first we need to give the key name, which is the grid name or grid key, and we need to pass the value, like this is a JSON object. And after that, this will also be one more key for edit grid, where we are passing again the JSON object. Did I answer your question?
Yeah.
Thank you, Suman.
Thank you. Thanks for the explanation.